Susan Bradley for CSO Online. Today, we're going to talk about some good news and some bad news. So first, the good news. Microsoft was going to release a patch in January to disable insecure LDAP channel binding. LDAP channel binding is specifically used in Active Directory and especially for on-premise Active Directory. Now, especially for those of you that have Active Directory based on older operating system, perhaps even Server 2008 R2 that's going out of support, you want to take note. So for those of you on older operating systems, you may still have this LDAP binding, insecure LDAP binding, occurring in your network. As a result of businesses asking for more time, Microsoft pushed off this event to March of 2020. That's the good news. Now here's the bad news. You may already be passing credentials for your domain admin account and clear text in your network, as noted in this 2016 post, identifying clear text LDAP bindings to your domain controllers. So this is not new. It's been around for a while, and attackers already know that you are probably doing this in your network. So what's a quick and easy way to determine if your Active Directory environment isn't set up for secure binding? So first off, go into your event logs into the Directory Services section and look for events 2886 and event 2887. In particular, if you have 2886 in your Active Directory security event logs, you'll see that you're already in an insecure position. Basically, your passwords are going over in clear text, and if an attacker gets inside your domain, they can grab those values and hashes and, well, just go to town with them. If you have an older domain controller, you may find that you've already had, inherited from years ago, a group policy setting specifically for this LDAP server signing requirement. If the LDAP server is none or not defined, that's not good. It actually should be to require signing, and you want to apply that in your domain. Now, I'm sure you're saying, but wait, how do I know if this is going to impact my domain? Good question. What we need to do next is turn up a bit of logging. There's a specific PowerShell command, or you can do a registry key, that turns on advanced logging for these events in your event logs. Then, about 24 hours later, you'll want to look to see if you've got any of the other events, 2889. Every single time a client performs what's called a SASL bind without requesting signing or a simple bind on clear text. If you see any of these 2889 in your event logs, then, you need to figure out what actual application is doing this and either go back, change out the application, or see if you can up the security. Now, if you find you're using that a third-party LDAP application that is requesting simple binding and not passing things properly and secured, try going back to that vendor and saying, hey, I need some help here. Can you adjust this and make this so it is in a secure manner? Or you can add what's called a SSL certificate to enable LDAP signing on your domain controllers. I've included a link to a blog post that goes into detail on how you add a certificate to allow for this secure LDAP binding. Once you've adjusted that application properly, then you can go back into your group policy and check on that require signing and apply it throughout your domain. And again, check before you do it. It may impact, hopefully it doesn't, but if it does, you need to make some changes to your network environment. As we start the new year, it's time to go through your end of year inventory. Review if you've got any insecure setups, review what you've done to your network in the past, what you want to do in the new year, review videos that we've got online at Tech Talk. And until next time, this is Susan Bradley for CSO Online. Thanks again.